Hello friends, now today I take you to a game which you love the most. We play the cards, playing cards, you know. You must be playing different games out of that playing cards in your vacation, okay? So, in Gujarati, we call them with the different names. So, what is this color in Gujarati? It's a kadi. But in English, it is known as spade. S-P-A-D, spade. These, in Gujarati we call falli or flower. In English it is called club. These we call in Gujarati chokat or charkat. But here it is in English diamond. And this is, we call in Gujarati lal. But it is heart. So these are the different types of cards you find in the deck of a card. You know how many cards are there in one deck? 52. So there are 13 cards of spade, we call it kadi, 13 cards of clubs, 13 cards of diamonds and 13 cards of hearts. Totally 13 for the 52 cards. Now in each type of the card, One is called S. Ekko in Gujarati we say. Then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11 we don't write, it is called Jack. In Gujarati we call Gulam. Q means Queen. Queen means Rani. And K means King. We call it Raja or Batsa. In the same way, 13 pages in club, 13 in diamonds and 13 in hearts. Now, in this game, we can attach probability. We can include probability in this game as well. So, along with the playing cards, we can go for certain questions also. We take one question from your exercise only. It is question number 14. One card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of the 52 cards. Then find the probability of getting, number one, a king of red color. Remember, king of red color. Red is not this type of card. Actually, you can say this diamond is also red in color and hearts is also red in color. So, totally pages red in color are 13 to the 26. So it is 26 upon total number of cards is 52. So it is 1 upon 2 probability. Okay? Next question. What will be the probability that picked up card is a face card? Face card means what? Gulam, Begum, Badsha, Jack, Queen and King. They are face cards. So 3 face cards in spade, in the same way 3 in each. So 3, 4 is a 12. So there are 12 face cards out of 52. Okay? So it is 3, 4 is a 12, 13, 4 is a 52. So the probability is 3 upon 13. We go for third. A red face card. Red means again we have to come to diamond hearts only. So out of the 12, 6 are gone, 6 are left. So it is 6 upon 52. You can simplify it to make the rational number, but this is how you can find out the probability. It is the Jack of hearts. Heart means only this. And how many Jacks in heart? Only one. So it is 1 upon 52. Is it clear? Next is a spade. Any card of the spade. So there are 13 cards in the category of spade. So, the number of outcomes favorable to event is 13 and total outcome is 52. So, it is 1 upon 4. 13 fours are 52. One more. The Queen of Diamond. Diamond means these only. In diamond category, how many queens are there? Only one. So, it is again 1 upon 52. So, this is how, if you know these colors properly, then you can find out the probability. So please remember the shape and the colors of these four traits. Now we take one more and you can understand how to find the probability. Suppose question number 16 I take, 12 defective pens are accidentally mixed with 132 good ones. 132 good pens are there. In that, by mistake, 12 defective pens are mixed accidentally, not purposefully, accidentally it is mixed up. Now out of this lot, one pen is taken out randomly, then determine what is the probability that pen taken out is a good one. So what is the total number of pen in the box? 2 and 2, 4, 3 and 1, 4 and 1. So total outcomes is 144. And you have to pick up one pen randomly out of it. So how many good pens are there? 132. So the number of outcomes favorable to the event is 132 upon 144. Simplify it and get the answer. Okay? So much easy it is. We take one more example. We get question number 18. A box contains 90 discs. How many discs are there? 90. They are numbered from 1 to 90. Every plate is given the number 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 90. If one disc is drawn at random from the box, now from the box, one disc is to be picked up randomly without looking into it, then find the probability number 1. It is a two-digit number. Now you have to keep in mind all the numbers 1 to 90 and how many two-digit number are there from 1 to 90. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 you exclude, so rest all are two-digit numbers. So how many left? 9 I exclude, so 81. And total number of disc is 90. So this is how you can find, you have to simplify the fraction, but 81 upon 90, that is your probability. Second one, a perfect square number. From 1 to 90, how many are perfect square numbers? 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square 25, 6 square 36, 7 square 49, 8 square 64, 9 square 81, and 10 square is 100. So it is not calculated. So these are the perfect square number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it is 9 are the outcomes favorable to the event. It should be a perfect square number out of 90. Simplify it and get the answer. And a number divisible by 5. Out of 1 to 90, how many numbers are divisible by 5? Say 5 ones are only. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, 5 fives are 25, 5 six are 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85, and 90. These all are the numbers which are divisible by 5. Calculate how many they are? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So it is 18 upon 90. Simplify it, I do it for you. 18 ones are 18, 18 fives are 90. So probability is 1 upon 5. Easy? So easy the questions are. We go for question number 19. A child has a die. Usually in the playing die we have 1 to 6 numbers. It is a special type of die. All the 6 surfaces contains A, B, C, D, E and again E. So these are the 6 outcomes. The die is thrown at once. What is the probability of getting A? Now check out of the 6, how many A you find? 2 times, okay? So it is 2 upon 6. Answer is 1 upon 3. And D, you throw the dice and the result is D. D is only 1 time, so it is 1 upon 6. Easy? Now see how classical probability can be applied to a problem that you can understand here. Suppose you drop a die at random on the rectangular region of the figure. One region is rectangular. The length and breadth are given. Length is 3 meter, breadth is 2 meter. And what is the probability that the die will land inside the circle with diameter 1 meter? Here is a circle whose diameter is 1 meter. So here no numbers are given, but the total outcome of the experiment, you will take the area of the rectangle. So in the denominator, it will be area of rectangles. Now die is thrown. What is the probability that it will land inside the circle? So here you have to find out area of circle. Got it? Now, one is diameter. So radius is 1/2. So formula for area of the circle is pi r square upon length into breadth, rectangle. So value of pi you can put 22/7, 3.14, sorry. And r is half. Half square is 1/4 upon 3 into 2. Simplify it and get the result as the probability that, what are the probability that the die lands inside the circle when it is thrown on this rectangular page. Is it clear? So simplification I leave up to you, but how to calculate, I have just told you. Now see, question number 21. A lot contains 144 ball pens. Total ball pens, how many? 144. Of which 20 are defective. 20 are defective. So how many are good ones? Out of 144, 20 defective are subtracted. Then it is 124 pens, they are good ones that you can calculate. Okay. Nuri will buy a pen if it is good, but will not buy if it is defective. The shopkeeper draws one pen at random and gives to her. What is the probability that she buys the pen? Ultimately, Nuri will buy the pen if it is of good quality only. She will not buy the pen if it is defective. So what is the number of pens having good quality? 124. So this 124 is the number favorable to the event. And total number of pen is 144. So this is how you can find out that probability, 124 upon 144. Simplify the number and get the answer. Question second is, what is the probability that she will not buy the pen? Now you can check either buy the pen or either not buy the pen. So they are complementary events. So for not buying a pen, it is 1 minus 124 upon 144. So ultimately, how to find out a complementary event, that we go for, and we can find the answer very easily. Now, we go for question number 24. A die is thrown twice. Single die is there. It is thrown twice. Now remember, a die is thrown twice, or two dies are thrown at a time, they are the same thing, okay? So die is thrown twice. What is the probability that 5 will not come up either times and 5 will come up at least one time? So you should have all the 1 to 36 outcomes. So it is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. 2-1, 2-2, 2-3, 2-4, 2-5, 2-6, 3-1, 3-2, 3-3, 3-4, 3-5, 3-6, 4-1, 4-2, 4-3, 4-4, 4-5, 4-6, 5-1, 5-2, 5-3, 5-4, 5-5, 5-6, 6-1, 6-2, 6-3, 6-4, 6-5, 6-6. I repeatedly wrote this so that you can get the idea how these 36 outcomes can be written when a die is thrown twice. Now, out of these 36 outcomes, we have to find the result. What is the probability that 5 will not come either time? Out of the two times, neither time the 5 appears. Means we have to find out the outcomes which are not carrying 5 at all. So you can check, I just cancel these events, these outcomes which carry 5. See, these are the 7 that don't carry 5. So out of 36, you cancel 7, it will be 29 upon 36. And 5 will come up at least once. So these are the numbers in which 5 comes at least once. So it is 7 upon 36. So this is how, if we know how to find out all the outcomes, we can answer any questions very easily. So friends, I request you that when you get your textbook, you go for the exercise and try to solve all the questions. And I give you my mobile number. Any query, anytime, you can call me or you can WhatsApp me on this number. 98256-93390. Okay? Thank you.